My name is Connie Deline. I am a patient with a spinal CSF leak. I'm also a physician. I think that having spoken with some other patients who have CSF leaks, I think it has been unfortunate that because it's not a really common problem, most physicians, neurologists, neurosurgeons aren't as familiar with it as they are with things that are more common, which makes sense.
My name is Wouter Schievink. I'm a neurosurgeon at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center. There probably is a huge range of outcomes for patients with spinal fluid leaks in the spine. Probably most of them never require any treatment, and the symptoms will be transient, and the symptoms only last for a few hours or a few days. On the other end of the spectrum are patients who continue to have symptoms in spite of dozens of blood patches, glue injections, as well as surgeries.
Any condition that isn't super common is that you need to seek out the physicians that have the expertise. It took me a little bit longer than it takes many patients. Getting the right diagnosis and treatment can really retrieve a normal life.
I think it is important to realize that for the vast majority of patients with a spinal fluid leak, the outcome is excellent. For those patients who continue to suffer in spite of all that we can currently do, I think the outlook for the future is very bright. In the coming years, we will improve imaging techniques to actually visualize the spinal fluid leak. Hopefully, we will be able to prevent leaks from returning, and also we will be able to develop new mechanisms of treating spinal fluid leaks.
For most people, CSF leaking is treatable and they can get their lives back.